County Commissioners Court is now in session at 10:15 a.m. All members of the court are present. Commissioner Roberts is joining us virtually. Good morning, Commissioner Roberts.
Morning.
All right, at this time, the meeting is called to order. If all participants will please rise for the invocation by Commissioner Young, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance.
Lord, I just want to thank you today for all of your many blessings. Please continue to keep Hardin County safe and keep us all safe during this storm. Be with us today as we conduct the business of the county. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Commissioner.
Thank you.
Item number three is approval of the minutes of the August 23rd, 2021 special meeting and the August 24th, 2021 regular and special meetings as presented by Linda Alston, County Clerk.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Cooper, seconded by Commissioner Young. Is that correct? All right, any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item four, consider approval of request to cancel all registered claims from the August 24, 2021 regular meeting and approval of cash statement as presented by Dana McWilliams, County Treasurer. Good morning, Ms. McWilliams.
Good morning.
First of all, how are you feeling?
Better.
So glad.
Not 100%, but better. I'm asking the court to release me of the liability of $806,993.18. In the cash report, in general checking, we have $12,915,886.76. In text pool, $321.09. For a total in cash funds of $12,916,207.85.
Move to approve this present.
Second.
That motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item five, discussion and possible action regarding annual review and approval of the Hardin County investment policy. Ms. McWilliams, you have presented the new policy to us, and is the only change the term of the policy, the time?
Yes, that's all. There's
everything else is the same?
Everything's the same.
So moved.
Second.
That motion by Commissioner Cooper, seconded by Commissioner Kirkendall, to accept and approve the Hardin County investment policy as presented by Deborah McWilliams. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item six, consider adoption of resolution 23-21, reappointing Deborah McWilliams as the county's investment officer pursuant to the Hardin County investment policy.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper to adopt this resolution as presented. Any discussion? Well, we appreciate the great job you do as our investment officer. I can tell you that the interest that Hardin County earned over the past 2 years when we were with the same bank, we just have a new contract, is that right? Was much more than we expected, and we appreciate you and your foresight on getting that done.
Thank you.
Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Thank you. Item seven, discussion and possible action concerning adoption of the fiscal year 2022 county payroll schedule. We have our payroll schedule presented here. Do any holidays interfere with our normal payroll schedule?
No.
This is the first time in a little while.
Yeah. Perfect. So we just have lots of Mondays that will be working on it.
I was that motion by Kirkendall? By Cooper, seconded by Kirkendall?
Yes, sir.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Thank you very much. Item eight, authorization to pay county bills as presented by Angela Gore, County Auditor. Ms. Gore?
The pre-approved expenditures for August the 25th through the 26th was $543,667.64. Pre-approved expenditures for August 30th through September the 2nd is $358,595.52. Pre-approved expenditures for September the 7th through the 9th is $510,759.92. Expenditures for Commissioners Court today are $737,321.41. Total expenditures and transfers is $2,150,344.31. Gross payroll for August of 26 was $535,363.16. Total transfers for that payroll was $861,542.92. Gross payroll for September the 9th was $515,435.89. And the total transfers for that payroll was $634,115.76.
Move to pay the bills.
Second.
That motion by Commissioner Cooper, seconded by Commissioner Young. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Thank you, Ms. Gould. Item 9, discussion and possible action to approve and accept for filing in the minutes of the court the district court orders setting salaries of the county auditor, assistant county auditors, and the official court reporters of the 88th and 356th Judicial District Courts for fiscal year 2022. Mrs. Gore, I know you participated in that public hearing with the district judges, and you've told me that the orders are consistent with the adoption of the fiscal year 22 budget. Is that correct?
That is correct.
All right. I move that we adopt the orders as presented to the court by both district judges.
Second.
I have a motion by McDaniel, seconded by Cooper. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Thank you, Mrs. Gould.
Thank you.
Number 10, consider and possibly approve overtime pay for Natasha Jones, who's classified as an exempt employee, exempt salaried employee, effective as of August 9th, 2021, utilizing immunization grant funds for the overtime she's working related to COVID-19. And this will all be grant funded to pay her for that overtime rate. And we are still under the disaster declaration by Governor Abbott and the President.
Move to approve.
Second.
That motion by Kirkendall, seconded by Cooper. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Natasha's glad to hear that. I think she's on here. Yes, she's on here virtually. Number 11, consider and possibly authorize a 90-day extension past Latasha Jones' anniversary date of August 25th and Amanda Larza's anniversary date of September 10th. For them to utilize their paid time off, as they were unable to utilize their paid time off due to COVID-19 infections and exposures of co-workers in their departments, requiring them to work or be at work during the weeks leading up to their anniversary date.
So moved.
Second.
That motion by Commissioner Cooper, seconded by Commissioner Kirkendall. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 12, discussion and possible approval to amend the Hardin County Military Leave Policy to reflect the addition of up to 7 days of paid disaster leave for fiscal year in accordance with House Bill 1589.
Move to approve.
Second.
That motion by Commissioner Young, seconded by Commissioner Kirkendall. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 13, discussion and possible action concerning order setting day of week and location of regular term schedule of the Hardin County Commissioners Court meetings for fiscal year 2022.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper. And I just want to mention that it does not appear any holidays affects that schedule. We'll meet the second and fourth Tuesday of each month right here in the same place. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 14, discussion and possible action concerning the setting of 2022 county holidays. We have our regular, I think it's 14 holidays, and they should be consistent with what shows on the standard U.S. calendar for holidays. I know that Ms. McWilliams and Mrs. Gore have reviewed this to make sure it didn't interfere with any payroll dates and have assured us that they don't. So that's important.
Second.
That motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Young. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Consider adoption of Resolution 24-21, nominating individuals to serve on Hardin County Appraisal District Board of Directors. We have the resolution in front of us, and I'll just name the names that are on here as nominated by the school district. Kenny Burkhalter, Lumberton ISD, Shirley Gillett, West Hardin, CCISD, John Landis, Coons ISD, / Warren ISD, and Eileen Lewis, Hardin Jefferson ISD.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper to adopt Resolution 24-21. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 16, consider adoption of Resolution 25-21 proclaiming September 14, 2021 as Golden Triangle Retired and Senior Volunteer Program Day in Hardin County. This is a request made by Lynn Huckabee with Golden Triangle RSVP Advisory Council.
So moved. Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Cooper, seconded by Commissioner Kirkendall. Any discussion? Motion to adopt 25-21 is passed. Item 17, consider adoption of Resolution 26-21 supporting the growing involvement of the disabled community in the political process and designating the week of September 13th through September 20th as National Disability Voter Registration Week. This is requested by Melissa McNeely, the Program Director at the RISE Center.
So moved.
Second.
And motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion? Yes, sir.
I'm answering.
Sure. Can you identify yourself?
Yes, sir. My name is Seth Wells. I'm the executive director.
Okay, Mr. Wells. How are you this morning?
Good, sir. Thank you for allowing me to speak. I'm the executive director of the RISE Center for Independent Living. Ms. McNeely couldn't make it today, so she asked me to be in her place. I appreciate your taking the time to allow me to speak a few minutes about National Disability Voter Registration Week. Just a little bit about RISE. RISE Center promotes the full inclusion, equal opportunity, and participation of persons with disabilities in every aspect of community life. People with disabilities have the right and the ability to make choices affecting their lives, the right to take risks, the right to fail, and the right to succeed. Our services are provided at no cost to persons residing in Jefferson, Orange, and Hardin counties, self-identifying as a person with a disability. So that's a little bit about RISE Center. We're a non-residential center, and we're stationed in Beaumont, and we help any person that self-identifies as a person with a disability to live more inclusively and accessibly in their communities and their homes. And what we're supporting is this Rev Up Texas referendum to make sure that persons with disabilities are registered to vote and all our citizens are registered to vote. If you don't mind, I'd like to read just a little excerpt from their information.
Yes, sir.
National Disability Voter Registration Week is a national nonpartisan campaign to register, educate, and prepare voters with disabilities for the 2021 elections and beyond. NDVRW is coordinated by the American Association of People with Disabilities and the Rev Up Voting Campaign. In the face of even greater barriers to registering and voting in Texas, the disability vote has never been more powerful. Despite being twice as likely to face voting barriers as people without disabilities, over 17 million disabled voters cast their ballot in the last presidential election. As the Rev Up Network, Crip the Vote, and other movements build the power of the disability vote, we believe we can close the 6% turnout gap between voters with and without disabilities. I am a resident of Beaumont, but upon my return from the military service, I spent a year living in Hardin County, so I have a special place in my heart for Hardin County. And as a veteran with a disability, one you might not be able to see, this is also important to me. My family and my generation and generations before me have fought for the right for all citizens to vote, and we want to ensure that all of our citizens have that right and are registered to vote. We have information that we can provide. It provides a link for persons that have never registered to vote or to check their registration status. They fill out their information. Oftentimes persons may not have a printer or access to stamps, so what happens is Rev Up the Vote Texas will, you fill out this information, they will send you a filled out voter registration card. You make sure your information is correct. You sign it, and it's also provided itself a stamped envelope to be sent to the Election Registration Committee. So that's just our way of ensuring that all Texans, all Americans have the right and accessibility to vote. And thank you for your time today. I appreciate it.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
Could I ask you one question, sir?
Yes, sir.
Are you familiar with the new legislation that just came out of this legislative session on
yes, sir.
The election?
Yes, sir.
You are aware there is a clause in that? That says anybody that receives compensation to assist someone to vote is a violation of the law. Does that fall? Do y'all fall under that?
We receive no compensation, no, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you,
Thank you, sir. And once again, that motion was made by Ms. Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper to adopt Resolution 26-21. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Item 18, consider adoption of Resolution 27-21, certifying that the county has made a grant to Nutrition and Services for Seniors, an organization that provides home-delivered meals to homebound persons in the county who are elderly and or have a disability, and certifying that the county has approved the organization's accounting system. This is a request made by Jancy Kimball, the CEO of Nutrition and Services for Seniors, and I did receive an email from her yesterday that she would not be able to attend today.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Young. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 19, consider approval of request for the Hardin County Historical Commission to receive a donation, or to receive donation, from the Hardin County Genealogical Society of all rights and personal property assets that the Genealogical Society owns in the museum of Hardin County. So, I was so worried about saying genealogical correctly, I messed up some other words. But that's a request by Mr. Jimmy McKim III, Chairman of the Historical Commission. And I do have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall.
Second
by Commissioner Young. Mr. McKim, anything you want to say?
No, just thank you for helping all you do with the Historical Commission. And museums are very important, and this is sort of a housekeeping process. It was a partnership with the Genealogy and the Historical Commission that started the museum. And actually, Genealogy took the lead on it, and we've decided it's time for that to be all folded into the Historical Commission. We're authorized by statute to manage county museums and things like that. It's just part of a natural process, and it's just time to do it. And I appreciate your consideration and approval to go ahead and do it.
Thank you, Mr. McKim, for all you do. Any other discussion regarding this item? All right, all in favor of the motion?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes, and Mrs. Austin, will you let the record reflect that Commissioner Roberts is no longer with us?
Okay.
He's trying to rejoin. He lost the electricity at his office, so he won't be part of that vote, but hopefully he'll be back with us in just a minute. But I know he's for that.
Thank you. One question.
Yes, sir.
We do have a transfer document, and County Attorney Minnick has approved it.
Okay.
And I need to get Floyd Boyette to execute it. Can I just get with you at a later time?
Yes, sir, that'd be fine. Sure.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Item 20, consider and possibly approve the reappointment of Ms. Gay Loki as a trustee of the Spindletop Center for a 2-year term effective September 1st, 2021.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion? Sure appreciate all the work that Ms. Loki does for Spindletop Center. She's enjoyed serving, and we appreciate that she's agreeing to continue to serve. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 21, setting a public hearing to discuss abandoning a 20-foot alleyway of Block 63 between lots 1 through 10 and lots 11 through 20 of the Western Town Site Company subdivision located in Sour Lake, Texas. A request made by Alex Parker, floodplain administrator. I believe he received a request from a landowner to do that. Has he discussed that with you?
I actually received the request.
Okay.
From Caleb Brooks, and they will be splitting it up to the other landowners also.
Okay.
We just need to have a public hearing because I can't get a hold of anybody with the Baptist Church yet.
All right. Well, I would recommend that we set the public hearing right before our next regular meeting at 9:45 a.m. on September 28th. Is that good for everybody? And Misty, does that give us enough time to make the notice in the paper? Just 2 weeks?
Yes, sir.
All right. If that's acceptable with everyone, we'll set that public hearing for 9:45 a.m. on September 28th.
So moved.
I'm sorry, I was getting Commissioner Roberts back in the meeting. So I have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall and Commissioner Cooper seconded that motion. And Commissioner Roberts is back in the meeting. Hello, Commissioner. All right, so we're setting a public hearing for September 28th at 9:45 a.m. We're on agenda item number 21 for Commissioner Roberts. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 22, setting a public hearing to consider a plan for the District Clerk's Technology Fund for the preservation and restoration of District Clerk's records. A request made by the District Clerk, Dana Holland. This is her annual public hearing to recertify her plan for the District Clerk's Technology Fund, and I've moved that we set that public hearing at the same time, 9:45 a.m., September 28th.
Second.
Have a motion by McDaniel, seconded by Young. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Misty, will you help me make sure that we get that in the paper today? Thank you. Item 23, consider and possibly authorize the county judge to sign state case registry and local customer service cooperative agreement between the Office of the Attorney General and Hardin County. A request made by Dana Hall, the district clerk.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Cooper, seconded by Commissioner Young. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 24, consider and possibly approve revised Hardin County Crime Victims Assistance Center job descriptions to comply with grant funding. A request made by Glenda Jacks, the director of the Crime Victims Assistance Center.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion?
HR has approved these.
Yes, sir. She worked with Glenda and made sure that they follow the guidelines of those grants for the Crime Victims Assistance Center. But didn't you have a lot of other questions you wanted to ask Linda?
That was it, Judge.
Get her up here in front of everybody. All right, any other discussion? Linda, we appreciate the great job you're doing over there. And all of your staff.
Okay.
All in favor of the motion?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. And Sheriff, we thank you for letting us come over to the new department. I know that she's been a loss to your department, but your loss has been our gain. Thank you. Item 25, consider and possibly authorize the county judge to sign second contract renewal participating services agreement with APRIS for statewide automated victim notification services. This is contract number 2021-224-4900-391-01. A request by Ms. Jacks.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Cooper, seconded by Commissioner Young. And this agreement was reviewed by Mr. Minnick, correct? All right. Just making sure. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion passes. And just for the court's and the public's awareness, that is just a renewal. It's just a new term of the agreement. It's just a change in date. Everything else is the same. Item 26, consider request to approve amended order calling for the November 2nd, 2021 constitutional amendment election. And accept the consolidation of precincts, a request made by Glenda Alston, County Clerk.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Cooper, seconded by Commissioner Kirkendall. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 27, discussion and possible action to accept an order calling for a bond election to be held by the Lumberton Municipal Utility District, making provisions for the conduct of the election and resolving other matters incident related to such election. Requested by the county clerk, Glenn Austin.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Young. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 28, discussion and possible action to accept Hardin County Emergency Services Districts 1 and 5 resolutions calling for an election to adopt a local sales and use tax at the rate of 2% inside the district's boundaries, excluding any territory in the district where the local sales and use tax is already at 2%.
So
this is requested by Mrs. Austin, but I believe she received the request from the ESD's attorneys. Is that correct?
Yes.
And I heard a motion by Commissioner Cooper and a second by Commissioner Young. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 29, consider and possibly authorize the county judge to execute an interlocal agreement with the City of Lumberton authorizing the Hardin County Floodplain Administrator to regulate and follow the City of Lumberton's ordinances and rules for subdivision regulations for the Long Lake development on FM 421 to set up a uniform standard for the entire development. This was our county attorney's idea, Mr. Minnick, and he is here if anybody has any questions. Mr. Minnick had, as you know, met with the City of Beaumont and got all of that lined out regarding the ETJ issue, and we signed that interlocal agreement. I believe it was at our last meeting. And then Mr. Minnick had made the recommendation that we enter into this interlocal agreement with the city of Lumberton. He and I went and met with Mr. Mayor Surratt and Mr. Swallow, their city attorney. After that meeting, Mr. Minnick and Mr. Swallow hammered out this interlocal agreement, and basically this would allow all of the plans to flow through both of our engineering firms simultaneously. It causes both of those engineering firms and our floodplain administrator and the city permits person to communicate with each other. And it also, which I think is very important to the citizens of Hardin County and as well as the city of Lumberton and Hardin County, adopts the same rules and regulations, subdivision rules and regulations that the city of Lumberton follows for the entire development, whether the development would be inside the city or outside the city limits, which would be regulated by Hardin County. I think it's a very good agreement. Again, it causes any future plans or plats that come to the county to be reviewed simultaneously with the city and their engineers, and vice versa. Any plans or plats that come to the city are reviewed simultaneously with the county floodplain administrator and our engineers. And it just causes to ensure that we don't cause any drainage issues for the city of Lumberton and vice versa, and also make sure that this development, when and if it goes through, is done uniformly. And all the lot sizes, all the regulations regarding lot sizes, streets, drainage, power lines being under the road, sidewalks, and all of that would be uniform throughout the entire subdivision. Mr. Minnick, do you want to add anything before we go forward and take any action on this item?
All I would add, Your Honor, is it does allow us to any plat that was to go through the city, we would be reviewing that. When we review any plat that goes to the city, basically we can make a recommendation to the city whether or not we have any drainage issues that could possibly affect us on our side and on the plats that are in the county, and vice versa. So when we do send the plats that we receive from the county to the city, they'll be able to do the same to us and make a recommendation whether or not that would affect the drainage in any of their plats. And so that, I think, is crucial, as well as setting a uniform standard for the subdivision if it is to be approved through the county.
All right. Any questions for Mr. Minnick?
Yes, Judge. I understand this, but if it came down to our governing body making a vote on whether to accept a preliminary or a permanent plat, we would have nothing to do with Lumberton's governing body having the same, correct?
That's correct.
Okay.
All this does is causes us to work together and cooperate so that we don't pass anything that would hurt Lumberton, and that they don't pass anything that would hurt anything that's going on outside the city limits of Lumberton. And I thought about something else really ingenious to say while Mr. Minnick was talking, but it slipped my mind. But there's some other discussion that we've had with the city regarding that. And just for instance, there's a preliminary plat that the city of Lumberton is reviewing now. If they did not approve that, we would not want to approve. They have 1A and the county will have 1B. If they did not approve 1A, we would not want to approve 1B because there's no way to access 1B without going through the streets that are in 1A. So that it just made sense. Matt, this was his idea to put this together to cause both entities to cooperate and communicate with each other, and to ensure that one party or one governing body didn't adopt something that would adversely affect the other governing body. It's best for the citizens. It's best for each of our government, city government and county government, our engineers, and even the developer himself. It would just streamline communications with all of us, and to make sure that drainage is the most important part to me out there, and would make sure that, just for instance, if Lumberton was to say, hey, we want you to retain more water, we would want to know that. And so we would want to try to do the same thing if that's what we determined. And vice versa, we could say the same thing. We could say, we don't think your retainage is enough. We want you to go back to the drawing board, and here's why. And we would want to make sure Lumberton knew about that if we did it.
So,
Matt, did you think of anything else? I'm sorry, question.
I would assume that the city of Lumberton and Hardin County do not have the same engineering firm.
Correct. They are using Schomburg and Polk, and we're still using LJA.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Young. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 30, consider and possibly approve the following job descriptions and pay rate. Financial assistant with a pay rate not to exceed $33 per hour. Building maintenance custodian with a pay rate of $14 per hour. And information technology technician with a pay rate of $25 per hour. These are all grant funded positions for the Health Services Department and is a request made by the Health Director, Sharon Whitney. So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion?
Yes.
Mr. Cooper.
Ms. Whitley, where did you get these figures for the salary?
Well, these are based upon, I did a salary benchmark based upon just for one position. Based upon the surrounding area.
I would think that one position should be higher, but have you done that survey? Thank you.
Which position?
The first one.
It should be higher?
I would say.
For the financial administration person?
Yeah. That's just limited knowledge on my part, but anyway.
We're not hiring us.
Okay, all right. Thank you.
I think originally you were going to try to hire a CPA, but you didn't, and the grant, this is covered by the grant 100%.
Yes, 100% by the grant.
Great. Anything else?
No.
All right, any further discussion?
Do these pay rates coincide with the Hardin County, with what we pay on?
The custodian pay rate does, and also the IT. I use what was already approved
for our
IT and custodian.
Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 31, consider and possibly authorize the county judge to sign emergency disaster right of entry and land use agreement for temporary debris storage and reduction site with Burl Estates. And the same agreement with Gonzalez property owners.
So moved.
That motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 32, present results of bids received and possibly award a successful bidder for a high clearance fire truck for the Hardin County CDBG-DR Infrastructure Emergency Services District 1 brush truck project. Ms. Sims?
I'd like to ask the court to table this one for ESD number 1, 3, and 6.
Okay.
We hoped we would have it ready to award, but we just need more time to evaluate the bids.
You need more time to?
Evaluate the bids.
Okay.
Need to discuss with each.
Move the table.
Second.
Can we move the table each out, all three items? Any reason we can't?
Or each?
32,
yes,
that's what she's asking, 32, 33, and 34.
Yes.
All right. Who is the motion? Motion by Commissioner Kirkendall to table item 32, 33, and 34 on this agenda, and that's seconded by Commissioner Cooper. Is that correct?
Yes.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? And you want those on the next agenda?
Yes.
All right, we'll put those on the very next agenda. And that moves us to item 35, discussion only of any item not on the agenda without taking any action. I would just like to, although most of you were here, some of you weren't here, and we weren't live streaming when we had the National Weather Service call. So just a quick update on Tropical Storm Nicholas. The tropical storm warning for Hardin County was canceled at 9:57 a.m. Nicholas made landfall as a Category 1 hurricane near Freeport shortly after midnight. And the storm center is currently located south of Houston, and it is moving north-northeast right towards us. As of 9:50 a.m., there were 234 residents of Hardin County without power, and Energy is currently working on those restorations. No Chico residents were without power at that time. All schools in Hardin County are closed today. I saw some messages coming through from the superintendents earlier, and it looks to me like most of them are saying they should be back up tomorrow. They'll make that decision this afternoon, and they'll make that public. But it looks like the schools will be back open tomorrow. At least that is their current thinking, if I read all that correct. Let's see. Disaster declarations have been issued by Jasper, Jefferson, and Orange counties. If there are shelters needed, there have been two identified in the region. One's in Jefferson County, one's in Orange County. As of 9:50 a.m., they were not open, but they are ready to be open if they're needed. And if shelters are needed anywhere else in the region, we will look at opening those up. The Office of Emergency Management is still at a level 3 readiness level, which is increased readiness. All four commissioners have made sandbags and sand available at each of their precinct barns. Sand and sandbags are also located at the ESD-2 fire station on Keith Road in Lumberton and the ESD-5 fire station on Commercial Drive in Pinewood. I'd like to thank y'all for all the work that you and your men do and your women do to get those sandbags ready and available for the citizens. And I know that y'all made several available and brought some volunteers in, some inmate labor in. Thank you, Sheriff, for allowing that to fill some of those sandbags and make them available for those who are elderly and disabled. So thank y'all for doing that, as you always do. No unmet needs have been submitted to the Hardin County Office of Emergency Management for this event, which is great. And honestly, based on our call at 10 o'clock, I think the worst, as far as the rain, is over. I think we'll see a few more downpours throughout the day, and we'll see some wind gusts up to 40 or 45 miles an hour, but we get that all the time. So there may be some more trees that come down, and hopefully they won't land on any houses or take down any power lines. But if they do, we'll get it fixed. We won't get it fixed. Somebody will get it fixed, as far as power lines go. Thank goodness we're not in the power line business. But we're very thankful that we have energy and Chico. Any other discussion of any item not on the agenda by any member of the court or official who is present?
Move to adjourn.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall and a second by Commissioner Cooper to adjourn. All in favor?
Aye.
We're adjourned. Everybody have a great rest of the week and be safe.